Hi, Tom here with this week's Circle Line at School drawing tutorial. One way to draw buildings on a street using one-point perspective. We can start this drawing by drawing a straight line across the page, a little lower than the middle of the page, and this line represents the height of the viewer of the image. Next, we can mark the vanishing point, as this is a drawing in one-point perspective, we just need one vanishing point, and we can place this vanishing point far to the right of the horizon line that we've just drawn. Next, we can draw a rectangle for the side of the first building. The rectangle needs to cross the horizon line, so it's above and below the horizon line. Everything above the horizon line we're looking up at, and everything below the horizon line we're looking down at. Next, we can draw two guidelines towards our vanishing point on the right. And then a vertical line for the receding side of the first part of the building. Next, we can draw a rectangle above the first rectangle as a guideline for the roof structure. Now we can use another receding line towards the vanishing point. Next, draw a receding guideline from the top left corner of the new rectangle towards our single vanishing point. Now we can draw a diagonal line for the pitch of the roof, for the angle of the roof line. Next, we can draw a new horizontal line from the top of the roof going towards the left. Next, draw a second line for the pitch of the roof. The angle is your choice, but each of the edges of the pitch of the roof need to be parallel to each other. Now we can draw a horizontal line across the first rectangle and then a guideline going towards the vanishing point. Next, draw a vertical line to show the new corner of the building, stepped back to create a jetty. Draw another vertical line on the left, and then a horizontal line at the base. A jetty is where each of the stories of the building gets wider than the story below it, so they sort of stick out as they get higher up. Next, we can add more details. Draw a rectangle at the top of the roof, receding to the vanishing point. Next, we can draw two small triangles within this rectangle for the edge shape of a new roof structure. Now we can draw two horizontal lines from the top points of these little triangles going towards the left, one long line and one short line because it's behind the front structure. And then we can add a little line at the left to show the edge of the structure of the roof that we've just drawn. Now we can draw a new jetty on the right. To do that, draw a series of rectangles that are narrow, but each one is wider than the one below it. And then we can draw receding lines from the edges of these rectangles that go towards the single vanishing point on the right. Make sure all the vertical lines and drawing stay vertical and parallel to each other. So when using one-point perspective to show the depth of buildings in a drawing, notice how the front of the part of the building facing us, we need to be looking straight on at it, and therefore it's not receding or coming towards us. It will just be a square or a rectangle or whatever shape the building is, without any distortion. But all of the shapes which are receding will be receding towards the single vanishing point. Now we can draw another roof structure for the building, a top triangle, but leaning towards the left. And then from the top of this triangle, we can draw a horizontal line, also going towards the left. Now we have the basic shape of this timber-framed building in one-point perspective. So one-point perspective uses one single vanishing point on the horizon line, which is also the eye level of the viewer of the image. The building is made up of a series of rectangles, which get wider as they go higher, and a slightly complicated roof structure for this old building. The next step is to add the visible shapes of the timber beams of the building and to add rectangles for the windows. Then we can draw in more details and more buildings along the street, using the same techniques of one-point perspective. Vertical lines stay vertical, receding lines go towards the vanishing point. If you'd like to learn more about drawing buildings in perspective, please visit my website, circlelineartschool.com. where you'll find details of my online drawing courses for beginners. Thank you for watching. Next up, see how the drawing unfolds. Thank you. Thank you for watching this drawing. I hope you found it useful for your own drawings and perspective. If you'd like to learn more about my online drawing courses, please visit my website, circlelineartschool.com. Thanks so much for watching, and see you next time.